Good morning, church. This is Pastor Scott from First United Methodist Church in Kirksville, Missouri. I hope you're having a glorious morning today and that you've sensed God's presence in many different ways around you. The topic I'm thinking about today is one about God's creation and how we so clearly see God in the beauty of the world. And it's easy to take for granted maybe the green fields and the forests and the fields of grain and all the things that we happen to see around us and realize that it's beautiful but may not realize the magnitude of its beauty. And I thought of a scripture, Romans 1:20, which reads, "Ever since the creation of the world, God's eternal power and divine nature, invisible though they are, have been seen and understood through the things God has made, so they are without excuse." And I think that's one of the best testimonies to God and God's ever-abiding presence with us is to look around and to realize that the beauty of this world and is not an accident. And human beings play a part of that. And we have a part of to maintain the world that we have. But the original creation of the world is something that happened over the eons with God's direction. And I just find that so much beautiful and encouraging. The song I wanted to sing for you today is one that's very much a standard in popular culture, been around since 1953, titled "I Believe." And the song "I Believe" was written by Irvin Drake and Irvin Graham, Jimmy Sherrill, and Al Stillman. And it was commissioned for them to write it for the Jane Froman television show. Now, I have to admit, I didn't know anything about the Jane Froman television show before I looked up about this song. But the song was actually commissioned as a way to kind of bolster the spirits of the country, because this was not too long after World War II and around the time of the Korean conflict. And so there was a lot of people that were concerned about the state of the world and the situation that everything was in. And so Jane Froman and her crew commissioned this song to be written. And it was a huge hit for Frankie Lane, who was a popular singer at the time. And it was the best-selling single recording in 1953 in the United Kingdom. It spent 36 weeks on the charts. And we also know that "I Believe" was recorded by many others. The one that I remember most clearly is Elvis Presley. But it was recorded by Louis Armstrong, Pat Boone, Glenn Campbell, Perry Como, Mahalia Jackson, Tom Jones, just to name a few. It's very much a standard song in many people's repertoire and one that is well loved by so many. But the song has got great depth because let me read the words to you to kind of remind you about it. But it starts off, "I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way. I believe. I believe above the storm, the smallest prayer can still be heard. I believe that someone in the great somewhere hears every word. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry or touch a leaf or see the sky, then I know why I believe." Such really brilliant words that really take us to another place. A place of assurance and comfort and peace. I'd like to sing the song for you now, and I encourage you to sing along. Just remember maybe when the first time you heard this song and what it might have meant to you. "I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone somewhere is every word. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I know why I believe. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I pray that you're encouraged by that today, and you go out and you look at the glorious world around you and say, thank God for this creation, and I truly believe. Go in peace and have a beautiful day.